After Mayor Aaron spent Christmas without his expected figures of Britt Baker and Bianca Belair, he holds on hope that Jillmas will have a miracle, but he has dived into madness. No, seriously, everyone, he thinks he's Kevin McCallister from Home Alone.
I took a shower today, washing every body part with actual soap.
Including all major crevices, including in between my toes and in my belly button, which I never did before, but sort of enjoyed. I washed my hair with Adult Formula Shampoo and used cream rinse for that just washed shine. I can't seem to find my toothbrush, but I'll pick one up when I go out today. Other than that, I'm in good shape. Oh, gee whiz! An update on my ringside exclusive Britt Baker figure that was supposed to be here last week! What's it say? Welcome to LumberJillville. Women's Wrestling Lives Here, and welcome to a review that I have been anticipating for a week, which is when I was supposed to get this Blood and Guts Dr. Britt Baker ringside exclusive figure. Now, needless to say, I know it was the holidays, and I understand things get delayed and whatnot, but it was a little frustrating for me this past Christmas because I pay overnight shipping for Bianca and Britt, and Bianca is MIA, and Britt has taken almost a week to get here, so it is what it is, though. I hope all of you out there got everything you wanted in time for Christmas. And remember, Jillmas lasts all month long. So that being said, let's take a closer look at this figure. All right, so before we take a closer look at the packaging and then open it up and look at the figure itself, I'm going to first and foremost say that being a women's wrestling figure collector and YouTuber, this is so refreshing. It's so awesome to see a women's wrestling figure exclusive because we don't often get those. So I'm so happy to have one in front of me and happy that it's Britt Baker. Now, needless to say, I am going to call it how it is and say that I feel like they missed a big opportunity here, and that opportunity would have been to include Thunder Rosa and make this a two-pack. I mean, let's be real here. The match that this depicts was actually won by Thunder Rosa, so it's a little confusing, a little bit of a head-scratcher why they did not make this a two-pack and include Thunder Rosa, especially because AEW has already released an exclusive two-pack that had Cody and Dustin, and they have an upcoming two-pack of Kenny and Jon Moxley from the Exploding Barbed Wire Deathmatch, which is possibly the worst ending in professional wrestling history, so to make this a single release for such an iconic match is a little head-scratching, honestly. But either way, you know, I'm happy to have this. I love Britt Baker. I think she's amazing, and I'm truly excited for this. I just would have liked to see Thunder Rosa included. But with that being said, let's take a closer look at the packaging. And this packaging, wow, this is amazing. Amazing to display MOC. Now, I do suggest that you get two of these if this interests you, because the MOC one looks amazing. But I can already tell you from looking at it, that when we open it up, there's going to be a lot of little goodies in here, including a newly painted face sculpt that it would be a lot of fun to have open too. So yeah, I would suggest buying two. That's what I did. This is the one I'm going to open for the review, and then I have one up top that is MOC. So on the front here, we have this nice open window where we really get a good look at not only Britt herself, but the t-shirt she comes with, her extra heads. And then we have the role model on the side there. On the bottom, it has Dr. Britt Baker, DMD. We have this really cool design here where it has the ropes going in the front. And obviously, we have blood splattered over the window and over the box. And that is awesome. And that is truly unique to have a women's wrestling figure with blood. I don't think we've ever had that before. So this is a one-of-a-kind, a groundbreaking figure, in my opinion, and it's awesome. Not much over here, but it's nice that we get a little side view through that window. And over here, we have an image of the beautiful Dr. Britt Baker. And on the back, we have a large image of that iconic shot from that night. I mean, this truly is iconic and will go down in history as such a big moment for the women's division in AEW, where they stood up and said, hey, we deserve more attention. We can do everything that the men can do, sometimes even better. Just give us a shot, give us the main event, and let us do it. Now, unfortunately, since this groundbreaking match, they continue to not really use their women's division as they should, but hopefully that continues to change because Britt and Thunder Rosa really tore down the house to make a statement. So yeah, with that being said, let's open it up. Now, before you cringe, remember I did say that I have an extra one, so don't get mad at me for opening this up, but I want to give y'all a closer look. So we have a little tape at the top here, and then we have tape at the bottom. Okay, we're just going to cut the tape at the top, though, I think. And we're going to try to pop it open. Okay, we got that. We got that. I really don't know why I cut the bottom. Forgive me. And it slides out like that. Maybe. Okay. Cool. And then she's on this little plastic bubble here. And we do have kind of a background here. And you could use that as a little bit of a backdrop for her display. And that's pretty cool. But I wish it would have came with a figure stand, because unfortunately we still don't have figure stands for the AEW figures. And yeah, this is kind of wonky compared to if you go look at that TNT Championship Cody Rhodes exclusive and the packaging he got. That would have been nice to have Britt in like really extravagant packaging with a really nice background. But I am going to keep this intact because that might look good. So here's the figure itself. Now I am going to cut away, and when we come back, she will be out of the package. I really want to be careful with this one. So here we go. AEW Dr. Britt Baker DMD Lights Out Match Ringside Exclusive. This attire and swappable heads is based on her groundbreaking Lights Out Anything Goes match on the March 17th, 2021 St. Patrick's Day Slam episode of AEW Dynamite. On this night, Dr. Britt Baker and Thunder Rosa would have a violent but well-executed match with so much emotion behind it. Thunder Rosa would come out victorious in the end, but both women would come out winners on this match that truly made a statement to the underutilized women's division in AEW. This match was truly amazing and really did give me goosebumps. So my overall first impressions of this figure, they're pretty darn good. However, I am going to say that obviously they did reuse the same body sculpt or body mold that they used in the Unmatched Series 1 Britt Baker, and I totally understand why they did, obviously. However, I think that's a pretty terrible body sculpt or body mold, and it kind of looks alien-like. You might not notice it until you compare it to the most recent Unmatched Series 2 Ty Conti figure. And yeah, it just looks a little alien-like here. The belly button's way too high, the legs are weird, and the feet are huge. So I understand why they reused the mold, but hopefully she gets an updated one in the future because she deserves that. And I also wish they would have given her more of a tan. She's a very tan woman, and here the skin tone's kind of pale. It might be hard to tell on this camera here, but yeah, they should have given her more of a tan. Now, we are going to cover the heads next, but first let's cover the accessories. She does come with that gloved hand for her right hand so she can perform the lockjaw, and that is awesome. We got both hands gloved for the Unmatched Series 1, but I'm okay with just having the one. And then we also got this t-shirt that has that iconic image from that night. Now, obviously, she didn't wear this on the night that this figure depicts. However, you could pop in this extra head here and put this t-shirt on her and depict a post-bloody match Britt Baker, kind of when she was on TV and everything. So that's really cool. Now, with that being said, let's dive into those heads. All right, so now let's take a closer look at the three heads that she comes with. Now, this one right here is the one that she comes packaged with, and honestly, it's my least favorite of the three. Now, the other two are pretty darn cool, and this one's cool too, but it's definitely my least favorite, mostly because I feel like that grin is a little goofy looking, a little silly. But looking closer at the blood detail, it's pretty amazing, y'all. It looks so amazing, especially in person. I can honestly tell you it looks so much better than even the pictures. And the blood pattern on her face looks real. I mean, it looks like exactly how the blood would form, and it's pretty awesome. Now, what's a really nice additional feature is the blood goes off into her hair. That's such an amazing detail that they added. And on top of that, if you look at the hair mold on both sides, it's a little ruffled and messed up to simulate wear from the match. And that to me is freaking awesome. That's such a great detail that they included. So yeah, I mean, I can't ask for anything better as far as the blood application. Now looking at the other heads, this is the other bloody one here. And as you can see, her face is almost in a smirk. So it's not, you know, a wide open smile like the other one. So I do prefer this bloody scan. This is the one I might display her with. And the blood pattern is a little different on this one. But once again, it goes into the hair. We have that ruffling on the side there to simulate wear. But it's a really cool bloody scan. I think this is my favorite bloody scan that she comes with. Now, the other scan she comes with, which honestly is pretty freaking amazing and a standout scan, is this one without the blood. The reason it stands out is this looks great. This looks just like Britt, and it's such an improvement over that Unmatched Series 1 Britt scan. Now, that one looked a little bizarre, and I think the main reason for that was the absence of eyeshadow, eye makeup, and eyeliner that she wears. And here we have that, and boy, does it make a difference. I mean, this is a stunning scan, sculpt, whatever you want to call it, and they did a great job, and it's nice that they included the eye makeup. So I am going to put this head on the body now and show y'all how it looks, because when I tried to remove the head, I ripped the torso apart, which it's very easy to do. So with that being said, let's just go ahead and put this on. Real quick, here's her with the other bloody scan, what it looks like on her body. And here's what this Britt figure looks like with that unbloody head on that body. Now, I am first and foremost going to say that I do suggest the boiling water method if you are going to swap the heads, because I'm happy to say that it takes a little bit of effort to swap the heads, and that's great because they fit on there nice and snug and secure. And yeah, that's awesome. That's why I didn't record it, because it got a little messy when I was trying to swap the head. So I do suggest boiling the water. But looking at this unbloody head sculpt, it looks fantastic, especially on this attire. Now, I know, what's the point of getting a blood and guts Britt Baker if you apply the head on display that doesn't have the blood? But that's why I suggest that you get two, because the one that's packaged, you leave MOC, it has a bloody head sculpt, that's great. And you could put this one on for display, because this scan, the sculpt, the makeup applied, everything about it looks excellent. Now, you can do part switching and put this head on the Unmatched Series 1 Britt. You could do that, but I really don't like swapping and switching parts. I like to have the figures how they are. But if you don't mind doing that, then I would definitely suggest that, because this head sculpt's too good not to use. Now, moving on down to her attire, as you can see, I did apply that glove. And that was real easy to switch out, so I just wanted to put that on. And then her attire here, everybody, it is metallic. It is silver as silver can get. It looks excellent. Really pops, really stands out, and that silver application is great. Now, on top of that, if you look closer, there is actually a lot of molding going on. It is just a repaint of the body she had in the Unmatched Series 1, but the paint is applied real intricate here. We have little red accented details going across that top all the way around with the lines. We have this black pattern around the top here. We also have the Britt Baker logo with a red outline. And on the back, if you lift her hair up, we have a tooth. Now, moving on down to her bottoms, we have that silver base color with a little red line accenting there, and that black pattern once again with the Britt Baker logo on each side. She has these silver leg sleeves with the red line and that black pattern going around. And then, unfortunately, the boots are the Space Moon boots. They're way too big. It looks like a member of KISS would wear these. So that's really the only unfortunate thing I would say about the boots. But yeah, I mean, overall, I think this attire looks great. I think it looks amazing. And I think this painted head sculpt, I mean, it's actually striking. The more that I'm looking at it, how much this resembles a Britt. So yeah, I think it's great. Now, since we have the scan on, before we do a comparison with her unmatched figure, let's see how she looks with this t-shirt on and that non-bloody head. So we will see. I think it's the first soft goods we've gotten with AEW women's figures, so that's definitely nice to see. And we'll see how it fits. Little Velcro fasten in the back. And yeah, honestly, it fits her pretty good. I really like how that fits her. Nice and snug. Looks pretty darn good at her. Now we are going to take this off, do articulation, and then compare it to her Unmatched Series 1 figure. Alright, so as far as articulation goes, these AEW figures are unbelievably articulate, if that's even a word. She can look left, look right. She can look down really well, but she can't really look up because of that hair sculpt here. Now, with the other hair sculpts, they are a little more pliable, so she has a little more head movement in those other sculpts. Her shoulder is on a ball joint here. She can also rotate in her upper arms. She has those double-jointed elbows, maximal elbow flexion there. Her wrist can swivel, also flex and extend. She has an upper torso movement. She can go in all different directions. She can side bend, she can ab crunch, she can extend, and go all over the place. She has that waist swivel there. Her hips are on a ball type joint, so she can go in all different directions. She has an upper thigh swivel. She has double jointed knees, which allows maximum knee flexion here. And then going down to her moon boots here, she can plantar flex and dorsiflex, and she can also rock to the sides a little bit. She also has upper boot swivel. So yeah, honestly, the articulation in these AEW women's figures, it's unmatched, no pun intended. So yeah, it looks great. All right, so next I wanted to do a little comparison between Britt's two figures. Now, it is important to note she did have a chase in that Unmatched Series 1, but I do not have it. It's very expensive online. So, yeah, can't really afford it right now, but it does have the same scan as that Unmatched Series 1, so you can get the basic idea as to how it would be compared to that Ringside Exclusive. Now, on the left, we have that Unmatched Series 1, and on the right, we obviously have that Ringside Exclusive, and to me, it's a no-brainer, in my opinion, which one really stands out, which one's better. And that is that Ringside Exclusive, and that's even without the bloody scans. If we just take a look at that alternate scan that doesn't have any blood on it, it is significantly better than the Unmatched one. Now, when I reviewed the Unmatched Britt Baker, I said that it's really not a bad scan, just the lack of the eye makeup makes it really look bad. But looking at it close, not only did they improve the scan by adding the eye makeup, but her eyes are bigger on this Ringside Exclusive, whereas the eyes look like they're barely open on the Unmatched. So it's one of those situations that when I got the Unmatched, I was like, you know what? That scan really is not that bad. It's really not that bad. But now that I compare it to this one, this scan is not very good, in my opinion, I hate to say. So if you're looking to add a Britt Baker to your collection, it's an easy decision to me, and I would get that Blood and Guts. I would get two of them. I would get two of them, like I said, to keep one MOC and the other one open it up and put this head on. Or like I mentioned, you could just swap heads if you'd rather do that. But either way, if you're looking to add one Brit to your collection, I would go for this, even more than the Chase. You know, I think the Chase attire is good, but it's still got that kind of crappy scan. Now, I did want to throw Unmatched Series 2 Ty Conti out there because I did just review her, and I gave her an 11 out of 10 because this is legit. In my opinion, the best women's wrestling figure I've reviewed on the channel. Everything from the head, the face, the hair, the attire, to the body sculpt. I mean, it's like a miniature version of her, and it looks excellent. And I feel like with this Brit, even though that head and face is tremendous, I feel like the body still isn't where it needs to be as far as a miniature version of Brit. I think they really need to do a new mold and kind of eliminate that alien type look, because if you compare them side by side with that Ty Conti, it looks like a whole different toy manufacturer, in my opinion. You know, so I honestly hope that Britt does get a redone, more tan, more jacked body for herself, because that's what she deserves. And yeah, hopefully they just keep that scan, because that scan is excellent. And here's one last look at Britt Baker Lights Out Match Ringside Collectibles Exclusive. Alright, so it's really hard to put a score on this figure because not only does it simulate such a groundbreaking night for the AEW women, but it's such a one-of-a-kind figure. So, with that being said, I am going to score it, but I'm going to score on the figure. I'm going to keep the packaging and the meaning behind it all to the side because, honestly, go buy it. You need to buy at least one because it's tremendous, especially if you collect women's wrestling figures. I mean, it's such a significant historic moment for the AEW women, and it's an excellent figure. But with that being said, I'm going to grade this as a figure alone, and I give the Ringside Collectibles Lights Out Match Exclusive Britt Baker an overall score of a 9 out of 10. I think this is a tremendous figure. It is very good. The accessories she comes with are really cool, including the t-shirt, the glove, and the extra heads. But even on top of that, the attire really pops, and that head and face scan and sculpt is levels above that Unmatched Series 1. Even better than I thought. So obviously, it's not a perfect 10 because they still have work to do as far as the body sculpt and body mold and also making the skin tone a little more tan. But other than that, it's a great figure. Thanks for stopping by LumberJillville. Women's wrestling lives here. For a first look at all future women's wrestling figures, make sure to hit like and subscribe to become an official resident today. Now stay tuned because Elite 91 Bianca Belair should be here this week. And I also heard that Robo Tamina is going to be bringing me a surprise figure to review by the end of the month. Have a great night, y'all.